machine reduces the side effects that patient used to receive with that machine almost to less than 5%.
The three newly procured TrueBeam linear accelerators have been fully installed at the Uganda Cancer Institute in Mulago. Dr. Israel Lutu, an oncologist at the Uganda Cancer Institute, explains that the full installation of these machines means a lot to the health system in Uganda. With these machines in place, Dr. Lutu explains that the facility will be able to treat more people than before. In a single day, the three machines can treat up to 170 people.
Even aspirin, when you take aspirin, you get some irritation of the stomach. So there are side effects, but minimized, very minimized, because it is precise to the cancer itself.
Designed to treat cancer, TrueBeam linear accelerators are flexible enough for radiotherapy in all parts of a human body. Dr. Sisi Banjide, an official from the Uganda Cancer Institute, revealed that with the development, the number of Ugandans flying out of the country for specialized cancer treatment is likely to reduce, since these services are now readily available and free.
We comprise over 20% of our cancer population. So even as children, as they come, we treat them.
When you are inside here, you will not feel anything. So the treatment is painless. You cannot sense it. You cannot sense heat. You cannot even smell it. You cannot see it. So the only thing you realize is that, you know, something has already happened. And in most cases, since we are targeting the cancer, it has happened to the cancer, but it has spared the normal system, the normal organs.
Meanwhile, government is set to offer treatment to Ugandans who are still grappling with the post-COVID-19 health complications. Dr. Ivan Chimuli revealed that, whereas many people were lucky to survive corona, the virus had drastic impacts on their respiratory health.
Patients that have continued to have chest pain, and there is no explanation for that chest pain. There are patients that have their work effort reduced prior to having done, if you compare them with what they were doing before they actually suffered COVID, meaning that the way in which probably oxygen is being utilized in their bodies has been compromised following having been sufferers of COVID-19. So we are seeing multiple presentations of patients with long COVID.
Currently, a number of health officials are undergoing training to identify the post-corona health effects and find ways of dealing with them.
One of the things that we have done, and I'm happy to also be part of the ministry, in terms of crafting guidelines of how to manage patients with long COVID, we are rolling out guidelines in managing long COVID. Shortly after, I think at the beginning of next month, we shall be rolling them out countrywide. And we are going to teach healthcare workers on how to handle some of these complications. The guidelines are still in draft form, and very soon they will be printed and shared with the whole country.
Medics also expressed concern over the increasing respiratory conditions in the country, with urban centers like Kampala having the highest numbers of patients. Report compiled by Shamshad Nalujia for the news.